I cannot have conversation with you no more, cause I changed me. I'm a little too, yeah, important for you.
I got some things up on my mind. I ain't trying to do it tonight. Ooh, yeah, yeah. I'ma spend what I like. Ain't even summer, got the roof up like July. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
How you feel? I can be yours. Where you going? What you doing? I said no. Are you with me? You know I could take it there. Say you love me.
Yeah. Baby, you should let me introduce myself.
So this morning I got up so that I can go and meet my little sissy, Kayla. She is executive, co-producer, and associate producer, some really cool short film, and I am happy to be a part of it. So she told me to come out and see if I saw some particular pieces that I thought would look good on me in the movie.
Hi, my name is Kayla Bush. I am a photographer, screenwriter, and occasionally a cinematographer. I met Treasure 2 years ago at her sexy summer sorbet. Today we're gonna be getting up pretty early to go to the Melrose Trading Post. So I decided to grab Treasure out of bed so we can go thrifting and get ready for this short film that we're shooting in Atlanta.
So I came out with my sissy today. She got me down here at the Melrose Trading Post for the first time. Even though I wasn't supposed to, I kind of was sneaking some footage in here, so everything might not be, you know, leveled.
That's amazing. I had to leave my wallet in the car because y'all know I'm fucking retarded. I had to leave my wallet in the car because y'all know, and don't let me see. I gotta support this person, and that.
You got some pretty cool stuff here.
Wow. I have got to check out this bad art. I don't know which one is actually the part that I like the most. Get up. I think I'm a pass. Oh, so fast in here. So many different. Oh my goodness.
It's like a shower cap, but that's not for the shower. That's for to wear out.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen
$20.
So today is Treasure's like first time coming to the Melrose Trading Post, and there's always like a lot of interesting things there. They have like medieval pieces and like these weird picnic baskets she seems to like. So hopefully she doesn't spend too much money.
Since I kind of have a serious spending problem on unnecessary items, I kind of have to budget myself, so definitely have to leave my wallet in the car. Have to take out a few dollars and place it in the bra.
This is like one of the most dramatic jackets that I have seen over this jump, though. It looks a little dirty, but it's dramatic as fuck. Oh my goodness. A diva is the female version of a hustler. Go to the next booth. Where's the lady? Oh shit, I'm sorry.
I saw her just a second ago.
These are all so pretty. I definitely want some because I love crystals.
Everybody knows that I love crystals. I collect them, I charge them, I bury them, I rub them, and I put them inside of me. So today at the Melrose Trading Post, I came across this super cool table, and the crystals were like literally magnetic. They were drawing me to them, so I had to grab some.
Do they range? Do the price range from size, or are they all 20?
No, this one?
No, they all
took it.
This one? Okay. So,
how did
you write
to
take the biggest one, right?
It depends. Sometimes the smaller one is the one that calls you.
This one?
Yes, please.
And ever come to the Trading Post over on Melrose, you have got to stop by Body by Cantina. Listen, when I say every crystal, she is popping over here. Y'all better...
It's 3066 after thanks.
Sometimes, whether if it's for a reason or for not, I like even numbers. You know, sometimes it's when you're spending it or when you're calling them or when you see them. It's just, it's, I got a thing about even numbers. So I wanted to make sure that what I was paying was an even number. So I got her to give me to me on an even number.
I know about odd numbers. I'm like that too.
Yeah. I can. I mean, yes. Right.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna
get you stuff. That's actually a good picture. I'm gonna repost it.
Thank you so much. Bye bye.
Bye bye. An amazing Sunday, the last Sunday of 2020, I spent at the Melrose Trading Post shopping with some small business owners, as I do all year around. And so should you.
So today I am coming to do a photo shoot for Junkie Boutique. This is my sister's brand. It is an amazing brand. She hand designs everything, so I'm super proud of her. And of course, you know, we always got to support our sisters in business.
So today we're going to be doing a quick little fashion or photo shoot for Junkie Boutique. So we have about like 5 or 6 looks that we're going to do a treasure.
Junkie Boutique, of course. You know, like I always say, you have to support who supports you, and my sisters is always going to dig on camera and in real life. Like, come on now, she constructs these, puts these together, and then she's going to put it on me. Then she knows how to line it up and everything, put the boobs and everything. Man, come on. Yeah, just.
Hi, my name is Krista Renee. I'm a fashion designer and the owner and designer of Junkie Boutique. I met Treasure about 2 or 3 years ago. I was in a position where I just needed to meet people for my brand's sake and just trying to connect with new people.
All content is good content, especially when you know how to edit it.
Do you want to use the brown or do you want to use white?
You know what, the white came out really good on it. It did. Let's get rid of this one.
Some of my favorite people working with is actually my sister and Treasure, just because of the way we can work together. Like, we know what we like and what we don't like, so we're able to get everything done pretty quickly. And she always comes prepared. Okay.
No, never need too much makeup. Just enough. And if you can do your own makeup, there's no reason why you should be paying somebody else, because nobody can do it as good as you. Oh my goodness. I think this looks good. Make sure that nipple ain't slipping, because this one like to come out and play. So y'all having glasses of wine and I didn't get none? The fuck? You know that's my new phrase. I told you, Kayla, the fuck?
Yeah.
That's what
girl. That girl.
She said, the fuck am I gonna do? Look at you. What you think they gonna do to me? The fuck? I said, yo, I could not breathe after that. I was checking my text messages. My boyfriend said I look good. I have sent him a little picture. But wait, before you start shooting, let me get this, because my wig needs to be like snapped together. It's not trying to say. Let me just tuck this bitch. Look, can you tell from the front? As long as you can't tell from the front, that's the only thing that really matters.
Treasure is looking like a Barbie.
I do, right? It's the Junkie Boutique Barbie. Yaddy. You know my ass. I don't know what they was up, but.
And then it's always like, this one. She just be like, look, what's going on? My ass is dead. Don't come for this booty. Alright. Ain't nobody tell him to call me. Y'all clearly just saw me talk to him. How long ago?
Kristian came through with the stuffing. Knew exactly how to do that. She was going.
So Kayla is also a videographer amongst the many, many hats that she has. But really cool thing that she does is take very amazing photos, and of course of me. But yes, cinematography, videography, photography, that is all her. She is amazing in it. So every time she shoots me, I always love the flicks.
You tell me when you're ready, girl, because you see me holding up this damn
You know, when I first picked up a camera and I started shooting again from like taking the longest break from high school up until now, it really gave me like a sense of peace because I didn't have to talk to people much. Like I would just go around taking pictures. And then I started taking pictures for my sister, Kristian, and then I started taking pictures with Treasure. So she's really been my muse for like a pretty long time now. And then when it comes to directing, well, cinematography, that's another thing that really makes me happy. And like pulling focus, I don't think people understand like how important that is. So in some pictures that you'll see, well, they don't make it onto Instagram, but they'll be out of focus. And it's just like, what happened to this picture? But I really love it. It's pretty fun. It's very soothing.
Girl, who is that?
Ooh,
hot sauce! We actually have a lot of cute ones in this. I'm about to say, Kristian, how many photos? I'm about to say this is our second full one for Junkie Boutique. The other one was that one that we did at the hotel.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna put a before and after. I did a photo shoot for Junkie Boutique before, and she always got something going on low with the titties. She loved to express the breast. That's what she be loving to do. She loved to express the breast. Kristian Renee, yes, she does. Junkie Boutique, follow her. Yes, most definitely.
She was putting on an event, which was a fashion show. I was in like desperado mode, and so I reached out to her to be a part of it. She was going to have a couple of influencers who are going to be spectating there, and so I just thought it was going to be an amazing opportunity. When I get there and actually showcase and do the event, it was just like an instant connection where, you know, she had this big sister vibe where, you know, because she's full of knowledge, she's full of just business savvy and business minded, and so I just took to her.
I'm about to change out of this outfit though. I'm gonna come back so y'all can see. Maybe.
The red boots on the carpet look so nice.
It does.
Oh my god.
Y'all know I'm used to smiling. I can't give resting bitch face. One fucking girl, like, she's the queen of that shit, yo.
Really?
Yes.
Wait, the fashion novel?
Exactly. She's the fucking queen of that fucking. I could never. Like, I'd be too fucking happy. See all these teeth, shit, I paid for these. I had braces for fucking 6 years. The fuck? I know I ain't that fat, but shit, I still be having to suck in. That skin, man, that's that damn skin. I'm fucking kids, man.
So working with Kristian is always like pretty much fun for the most part. But you know, as sisters, we always like bicker at one another because she wants to do one thing and I want to do something else. So hopefully today, like, we'll be on the same page.
I like things a certain way, and she likes things a certain way. So sometimes we can clash. I don't know. I hope we don't clash today. Hopefully everything goes as planned. We have done these before, so
I'm hoping that we just know where each other is coming from.
Oh, I love that! Yo, my ass is way bigger than I be thinking it is. It's really fucking big, bro.
Patty, in a second. Yes, I am. I'm gonna give all of my waves and my haze and everything. Oh, shit, we got 1,100 people over here right now. Oh, y'all feeling my photo shoot? Hey, Junkie Boutique, make sure y'all shop with them. Get your exclusive 2Bs.
She custom makes these, and they come in more than one color, too. Different designs, different styles. Yes, there we go. Throw them hearts, throw that love. Junkie Boutique, follow them. Check my post previous to this, and I tag them in my post. Yes. So we still firm?
No, back, remember?
Okay, hello. Y'all just want to get all of my booty today. Damn, y'all some stuff from the back. No, I've been doing this shit. Y'all better check a nigga background. I've been booking, doing photo shoots since what, 2011? Since 2010? Double XL.
She was saying doing it with the bralette.
We'll put them on and see how it goes. Whatever you want me to do.
Okay, so let me see. Closing out my life. Ooh, a total of 13,437 viewers.
Wow. That's cool.
Just gotta make sure y'all clean up my surgery incisions. Yo, I swear I do not be thinking my ass is that big, girl.
Exactly.
Black photographers, black designers, black creatives, black models, black bottles. Yes. Yes.
Honey. And then it's permanent.
Oh my God.
What? See, I don't be knowing none of this stuff.
I have what you want. You can call your fans gems.
Oh yeah, I already said that. I even said I was gonna change my radio station to Jim's radio.
I love that. That's so pretty.
The way I found out about the filters was weird because my cousin is in jail, but he got a clothing line and he plugged me with the guy that makes them because he's in Russia.
These niggas in jail ain't playing, bro. These motherfuckers gonna come out. They gonna come out like
they gonna be the new CEO.
They gonna be like, yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I was locked up for 15 years, but I still got 15 million.
Now, but look, and my cousin, he got the homies on the street that's doing all the groundwork, going to the factory, getting all the stuff made, the sweatsuits, the shirts, and all that.
That's all you need. That's what was the key? Is that he got the homies sitting there doing that? Okay, yeah, that's a team. If you ain't got the team, you ain't going nowhere. Because if you at an industry film, whatever industry it is that you are in. You ain't doing nothing if you ain't got no team. If your team is not coming at you and you ain't got nobody pushing behind you, you only go as far as your team. So that's the first thing you do. Only one person can be the nucleus. Everybody else gotta be the legs, gotta be moving around. So that's the main thing. So everybody knows that it takes more than one person to make anything go. Nothing that anybody ever achieves is done solely. It's strictly about how strong your team is. And as long as your team is strong and everybody knows their position, you're gonna go in the right direction.
People need to figure out where their placement is.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That's what it is. People need to know their place. That's what it is. That's actually one of the biggest things that I was sitting in heaven to confirm with people was like, okay, you know, like even with the China situation, what y'all seen firsthand, you know what I'm saying, how that fucking goes. But yeah, even with that situation, I be telling people, I be like, don't feel sorry for me, don't feel bad for me, because at the end of the day, I'm a genuine bitch, and I fucking loved her, and I was a part of her team. I was pushing her to get further, and she got there, and not for nothing. I am a nucleus. I'm a powerhouse by myself. I know that, but I'm also legs, mm-hmm. and I don't mind being legs. Like, see, like, even over here, I initially, what the fuck, this is supposed to be a shoot for me. I ain't even put on nothing of mine yet. Nothing yet, right? What the fuck? Because my sister needs somebody to fucking model her club. Give them all the love that you could have
had. Had it cut you off, now you got it back. I just need to, like, curl these and wild vibe.
So I met Kristian when she came to be a part of my fashion show. This was a couple of years ago. It was my first time actually doing a fashion show, the Sexy Summer Soiree, and she was a up-and-coming designer from the LA area. So she reached out to be a part of the designer team. So I checked out some of her work and I liked it. So that's how me and her actually met. Shortly after I met her, we became friends. She was at the fashion show. We just really actually clicked. We even spent Thanksgiving dinner that year together. So since then, I mean, we just family now.
We are doing a Junkie Boutique photo shoot. I am just at the end of finishing my collection, and so I'm working on promotional tools in order to get the collection out a little more. I'm just really excited and thankful to have Treasure on this project. She agreed to come out and do the photo shoot for us. She, you know, we just have a relationship where, a relationship of respect. I'll never ask her to do anything for free and vice versa. So that's what I like about, that's one of the aspects that I like about our relationship, the level of respect, and just the, it's just to help each other, push each other forward in our craft and what we love to do.
As far as I'm concerned, you're performing brain surgery right now.
This is called a hem. It's called a seam and a hem.
She has sewn
me all the way to hell up in this. I ain't never gonna be able to get out of this.
Kristian is super savvy with a needle and thread. Like, she literally pops them threads off and stitches it back up so fast.
Apparently she must think that that I'm not holding in my stomach at this point in time. I know you can still see the fupa under there. But under the fupa, I'm trying to breathe. And I'm gonna pass out in a minute.
I've been designing for a minute, about maybe six to eight years. And so my career started off in designing for lingerie. I was a lingerie designer for a small company. Some of the designs that I did with them, I was able to see my designs on influencers and personalities, people that were on like Love & Hip Hop, some models like Maxim, models across the country, Swedish models. It was very exciting to surf the web and actually see those pictures out on the web, and these different people liking my designs enough to showcase them. So now I am self-employed, working full-time on Junkie Boutique and getting the brand into stores across the nation.
Yes, y'all missed my last look. I couldn't jump back on here, but this is look number five. Five looks in this bitch. Yo, we're gonna have some people join me on my story. Who wants to join in? Send me a message.
I was on here live earlier, and I was telling them I was doing the crybaby shot, and I said, but I can't show y'all. I told them Megan got that shit from me. She got that shit from me. All bitches say that shit, right? Yeah, that's what all bitches say. Look, somebody like, yes, they all said. Don't be laughing. Everybody's laughing. They think it's funny.
That's because you're angry, but you turned up at the same time.
That's because my energy, my feeling, as soon as I walked in, my energy today is on. Yes, it's the last Sunday of 2020, self-care Sunday. And I said, I am doing something for myself and for my sisters today. They trying to kill us. No, they trying to kill us. They said it's new strains and we ain't talking about Ebola because I can't get Ebola. Everybody, look, it's been too many, swine flu. We done had all types of shit. Sometimes shit, big shit comes out and then they fucking cure the shit. Look at polio. It was people walking around trying to put iron lungs in their body. Or sitting, you know, at one point in time, that shit was real and people was real scared. 1 year later, It was a vaccine for polio. Y'all better check y'all card. We all got polio vaccines. Just like, see, now, we've been vaccinated for chicken pox now, but I got chicken pox marks. I had chicken pox in my life. I was scratching and itching and all of that other shit. I was in the tub with my little brother in the oatmeal baths. Y'all don't know about all that, man. I'm fucking hungry. Y'all know I don't eat. I fast through the night, man. I don't eat until 12 p.m. every day, and it's past 3. That's the only reason why she was even able to sew me into these pants. Y'all can't keep starving me like this, man. I'm gonna walk out of this. Fuck this shit. An amazing way to end a beautiful self-care Sunday. Photo shoots, good energy, positive people. You feel me?
Today went pretty well. We were able to knock out just about 6 looks. I feel like there may have been more, honestly, but she was really just knocking them out like back to back to back. So I feel like I need to thank like the photographers that came before me, because Treasure is so easy to work with because of all of the poses that she has. And then with Kristian and like just how quickly she's able to dress people, I really feel like we all make like the perfect team. And I feel like that's really like one of the most important things in entertainment, is having like one of the best teams, and we definitely had that.
So I believe today went really well. We got a lot done. We definitely shot more looks and more outfits than I had intended on. So I'm really excited. I'm really excited to go over to Phalece to see how everything turns out. I hope Treasure is happy with some of the new items that I was able to give her. And yeah, I just can't wait to see how everything plays out.
Thank you so much, Kristian.
Oh my goodness, I
loved everything. I cannot wait to the show.
Oh my goodness, they came home.
Yes! Oh my goodness! Woo! Put it in, put it in, put it in.
Ooh, love the smell.
Yes, I know, right?
Alright.
Alright, boo.
Alright.
Always a great time when I see my sissies. Just always great vibes. We always click together, whether it's we shooting or we just chilling, events or going swimming.